chores are good at a lot of things, but house chores ain't one of them.
With my gone, someone has to be brought from town.
Now, just a minute.
They marry?
They're spoken for.
Oh,
Just spoken for. You had me scared.
I tell you, they're promised.
Well, a lady can change her mind, can't she?
You're wasting your time. You won't find a girl to marry you in this town.
We'll never set my mind to something yet but what I didn't do it. Whether it's plowing 20 acres in a day or dropping a tree within an inch of where I want it. I came today to give you a wife, and I don't aim to go back empty-handed. You're all pretty and fresh and young, and I'll keep you in mind. But I ain't decided on nothing till I look them all over.
Bless your beautiful heart.
Last
day. Yes, it is.
When swamp a gun and a swamp a mule, and the two feet would be one big fool. Or pay your way through cooking school. If a you would say I do. Bless your beautiful eye.
Gotta be right to be the bride for me.
Bless your beautiful heart.
works you hard.
Oh, Mr. Sanders is my father. Both my parents passed back out on the trail. We got a late start and got caught in the winter storms. I moved into town some months back.
All alone?
I can take care of myself.
Well, I can see that. Really? Set a minute.
I gotta do this first.
Now you listen to me. Set! I got a farm. A good farm. There's a house on it. There's timberland and high grazing meadows. There's sheep and milk cows and 50 acres of wheat. Well, the only thing I got, it ain't got a woman. How about it?
How about what?
How about marrying me? Millie, did you hear me?
Sure I did! I don't know anything about you, how you live and things.
Well, I know what you're noticing. And it would have been fitting to meet on a Sunday leaving church. Then 6 months later, I'd ask if I could walk you home. Then for the next 2 or 3 years, I would have sat in your front parlor every Wednesday night. And then finally, I'd ask your pa if I could marry him. Lisa, that's the way my ma would have wanted me to do it. But here there ain't time. I gotta get back tonight to tend to my stock. It'll be another 5 months before I get back down here after the harvest. Are you really gonna keep a fellow waiting all this time just for some little Eastern fall or all?
Well, I have to finish my chores first.
I knew the minute I laid eyes on you that you was the one for me. Yeah!
How far is it up to the farm?
About 12 miles.
Oh, most people think that'd be pretty lonely, but I can stand some loneliness after this restaurant.
Yeah!
Always when I hear those rowdy men yelling for the dinner, I think how wonderful it'd be to have just one man to cook and care for.
My wagon's down in the grove. I'll rush up the preacher and get us a ring. I'll give you a shave. And a bath. I'll see you in 10 minutes.
Adam!
You're not changing your mind now, are you?
No.
Good. Well, I'll be right back. Yeah!
Thinking about spending time alone with Adam Ponte?
Well, I guess you can see that roof. Sort of.
He is so handsome. Do you like him, really?
I guess so.
We're getting married.
Getting married?
I didn't even know you were being courted.
I wasn't. I just got 3 years worth in 5 minutes.
Millie Braden, I don't believe what you're doing.
Aren't you the one who's always telling me to get myself married?
One of our town's boys, Millie.
Not to a scruffy mountain man?
You know, I tried. But I think of saying yes to one of them and an awful sinking feeling would strike me. I just couldn't do it. When I said yes to Adam, I waited for that feeling, but it didn't come. I feel just fine.
Oh, Millie, that's so romantic.
I can't believe it. Somebody pinch me. Ow! Alice, honey, it's just an expression. I've got to hurry, and I've got to pack.
We'll finish this, Millie.
I'll do the packing.
Oh, we'll never see our Millie again.
Oh, never.
Ever.
Never.
Ever.
Never. Don't worry, girls. She'll be back before the first snow.
Don't forget my books. Plutarch's Lies in the Bible. They're all my parents left me.
There's something you should know about Adam and his family.
I know all I need to know. There's a real goodness in his eyes. Just like my pa. I always dreamed a man like that would come and take me away.
Well, I'm worrying about you and your dream. When you wake up, you're gonna be married.
And Marion's for life.
Could have married long ago. I said no and fellas came proposing. Bankers, teachers, preachers too were among the men I could have chosen. Kept my feet on the ground. Now
he came. Jupiter's wife.
Well, I'll be a monkey's uncle.
Hey, Eve, Dan, he got married.
These here's my brothers, Daniel and Ephraim.
How are you, Brother Daniel, Brother Ephraim? Which one of you is Ephraim and which is Daniel?
Me!
Oh, and this here's Benjamin.
How are you, Brother Benjamin?
Fine.
You didn't tell me you had brothers.
Yeah. Must have been the wedding. Threw it right out of my head. Let's go over to the hops.
Do you all live around here?
Not around. Here.
Oh.
Let's go in the hops.
Adam!
Only one and one.
When you went
like that, we're gonna be married.
And married for life.
Fellas out here, Melrose Brother Middles.
I married seven brothers, became seven wives, seven mothers, all those gaping goats in old muddy boots. I'm locked in a cabin of brutes. I'll have to make a million strips of bacon. And what about the eggs I'll have to fry? All my faith in marriage has been turning flapjacks, baking bread, making pie. I'll be fixing muffins, turkey stuffings, chain to the kitchen till I die. I married seven pumpkins, and I like to squash them like pumpkins. I should take every pan, smash every man. Wipe out this Pontippy clan.
10 o'clock. An hour past your bedtime.
Here's two, Adam.
Yeah, well, come to think of it, I am a mite sleepy.
Who is it?
It's me, Adam. Your husband.
Come in, Adam.
Good night, boys.
Good night, Adam.
I thought you'd be in bed.
Oh, I expected you'd think that.
You must be kind of tuckered out. It's been a bright, busy day.
I'd say so.
Shall I turn down the covers?
You can if you like. But I'm not going to bed. Adam, you don't want a wife. You want a cook. A washwoman, a hired girl. Well, a hired girl's got a right to a sleeping place of her own.
Now, Millie, I didn't mean to.
To trick me?
Millie, before you know it, those boys will be married and living on their own. If I told you beforehand, you might not have come with me. I wanted to marry you, Millie. I wanted it real bad.
Sure you did, because you knew I was young and strong and there was still a lot of work in me.
Well, I suppose that's partly true. It's a rough life up here, Millie. There's trees waiting to be felled, land waiting to be plowed and fenced, stock to be fed. A man needs a wife who can work alongside him.
Well, I'll work alongside you, Adam, but I won't sleep alongside you.
Millie.
Good night, Mr. Ponapee.
Oh, I'm just giving her time to get out of her duds. She's a little nervous.
She's a little nervous.
Today to happen again. I want to trust you. Can I trust you?
You can, Millie.
Did you really want to marry me?
Well, sure I did. I already told you before, real bad. You were right spunky down, Millie. I like that. And besides, what dumb fool wouldn't want to marry a woman with a figure? That a man's not supposed to notice. Hair that sounds better than a thoroughbred after a brush.
I guess I was pretty mad. I built up such a store of dreams. I know how it is with your brothers. You being head of house and all, you've got to keep their respect. I wouldn't want you to lose face. All things considered, maybe you'd better come back in.
Oh!
No, Adam!
Oh,
my brothers. If you're looking for your outside clothes, they're out drying in the line. Oh, I came in before and got them. I couldn't get your inside clothes, though. I'll take them now, please.
Whoa. Our underwear?
Yes, your underwear, that you're sleeping in.
Okay, no. Oh, hold on. Where is Adam? We want to talk to Adam.
Yeah.
He's out in the field. He had his breakfast more than a half hour ago.
Well, I want to talk to Adam.
After breakfast, there'll be plenty of time. I got hot muffins waiting. Crisp bacon and hot cakes.
Hot cakes?
Steaks. Fried potatoes.
Potatoes.
Fresh ground coffee.
Coffee? I love coffee. Shut up, Frank.
Just throw a blanket around yourselves and come on out. Well, do I get that winter underwear, or do I have to come in and take it off of you?
Hey, don't listen to her. She wouldn't dare.
Oh, wouldn't I?
All right. Get it.
Thought so.
Chose for his wife.
Why, thank you, Gideon. Have you ever thought of being with a girl of your own?
Well, I've thought about it. Gideon!
Oh, well, there's nothing wrong with that. The rest of you must have thought of girls, too.
I can't say that I have, Millie. Caleb, I know you have.
Well, if it bothers you that much, there's plenty of other things we can talk about.
I think about girls all the time.
Joking about it is just another way of talking about it. Let's just find something else to talk about.
my brothers don't know how to act around girls.
You can learn. I'll show you. Look, I'm the girl, and you meet me coming out of church. You raise your hat. Come on. Come on. Daniel, what's the matter?
My hair ain't combed.
Now, you gotta say something nice. Go on, Gideon. Say something.
Would you care for some chawing tobacco?
Girls don't chew tobacco, Gideon.
Oh.
Try again.
That's not for a coon hunt.
There's still time to learn. Why, we've got 1 whole month till the next social. But you've got to remember, you'll have competition. Every one of those girls down there's got 5, 10 fellas buzzing around her.
We'll clear them out. First thing,
the whole lot.
No, yeah. No, that's exactly what you mustn't do. Show those girls you know some etiquette.
At a what?
Etiquette, Gideon. Now, when you meet a girl, don't grab for her like she was a flapjack. Offer her your arm. Ask her for a stroll. And then you tell her how pretty she is. And then you call her my dear, my darling, my precious, my pet. Go courtin', oh, it sets your senses in a whirl. Go courtin', tootin' up to go and see a girl. Oh, it's fun to hunt and shoot a gun, or to catch a rabbit on the run. But you'll find it's twice as sportin' going courtin'.
Like this, Millie?
Oh, look, you gotta wait for her, Caleb. Now there's lots of things you gotta know. Be sure the parlor light is low. You sidle up and squeeze her hand. Let me tell you, fellas, that is grand. You hem and haw a little while.
My name's the best.
She gives you kind of half a smile. Cuddle up, she moves away. Then the strategy comes into play.
No!
Well, come on, don't you want to learn?
No. Yes, ma'am.
Go courtin', if you find it hard to break the ice. Go courtin', here's a little feminine advice. Roll your eyes and heave a little sigh. That's it, Benjamin! Grunt and groan like you're about to die.
Oh!
That is what's known as mocking. Go courting.
How about sparking?
Parlor's darkened.
Yeah.
And you're longing for a fond embrace.
Uh-huh.
How about petting? How about sofa setting? Suppose she ups and slaps your face.
Yeah!
Just remember, blessed are the meek. Don't forget to turn the other cheek. Soon you'll find you'll both be larking. Going sparking. Going dancing. At a fancy ball or minuet. Come on, Caleb. Going dancing. You'll impress her with your etiquette. Why, thank you, Ethro. Frank!
You mean that men are learning how to dance?
Yes, it came direct from Paris, France. It'll help with your romancing, going dancing. All right, boys, let's make some room. I'll show you how it's done. Ephraim, to the right, to the left. Down, up. Come on, to the right. Oh, Caleb, your left. Now, why would a big, strong man like you be afraid of a little thing like dancing?
Aw, shucks, Millie.
All right, boys, form a circle.
Okay.
partner. Right hand to right hand. Not that right hand, Caleb. Ready? Go.
Thank you.
seen that before.
Never. Is something terrible gonna happen?
My mama says that strangers mean trouble.
Double trouble.
Well, where they come from?
Heaven. Oh, kinda good looking.
And all as tall as church steeples.
Alice, which one do you like?
The handsome one.
Oh, I'm so happy to see all of you.
Oh, it's Millie and Millie.
Is it Millie and Millie?
Adam, I'd like you to meet Zeke and Jeb. And this is Nathan. It was his family that took me in when I first arrived in town off the trail. Matt and Luke, and this is Joel. This is my husband, Adam Pontipi.
We know Adam Pontipi. He threw a man through a single piece window.
Huh. Well, I plumbly forgot about that fight. Wasn't that when those three
Wait, did you boys bring in the rest of the stuff from the wagon? Boys, you can see our boys have their hands full. Please. Oh, girls, excuse me. Would you mind showing our brothers with the pies and such I bake for the social?
Millie, it would be an honor.
Dorcas, this is Benjamin.
I'd be most pleased, ma'am, if you could assist me and show me where to put this pie.
I'd be pleased.
Really? Where would you like me to place this?
Frank, I'd like you to meet Sarah. Sarah, this is Frank.
Ma'am.
Here. Would you follow me?
I'd love to, ma'am.
Millie, it's nice to see you looking so handsome.
I mean, good. Thank you, Ruth. Caleb, if you'll just follow Ruth.
To the ends of the earth.
Daniel Ephraim, Martha Liza. Oh, I'm so sorry. Daniel Ephraim, meet Liza and Martha.
Pleased to meet you.
Pleased
to meet you.
They're pleased too.
After you, ladies!
That's all we've got, boy.
Oh, Alice, I'm sorry, but that's all.
Can I show you to the table anyway?
You know, you're the prettiest girl I ever acquainted.
Oh!
Can I show you the table, ma'am?
You know, it wouldn't hurt you to learn some manners, too.
What do I need manners for? I already got me a wife.
Ha! Come on, everybody. Let's get to the dancing.
I'm gonna get a drink!
Millie, what do we do now?
Now don't fret. There's
hand. Let Benjamin offer him your hand. Hey, quick! Don't worry. We'll get him an arm wrestling.
Yeah.
Rack him up!
After you.
Oh!
Witch Hazel, and try not to smile for a few days. Next. Two beefsteaks. Keep them on that eye and don't mess with it.
See?
Thanks, Melanie.
Thank you.
Next.
Frank.
Kick in the pants.
Next.
Oh, swallowed up knuckles and a loose tooth.
It's a wonder you have any teeth left at all.
I'm sorry, Millie. Honest. Those folks jumped at him.
I know you all did your best.
Millie, I feel kind of strange. Like I ain't eaten, except I ain't hungry.
Well, if what I think ails you, Gideon, no doctor's gonna help any. Alice is sweet, isn't she?
I never knew dancing could be such fun.
Well, I have nothing to say to you.
You feeling beauty? You looking kind of peaky.
Oh, I ain't sick, Adam. I just got the shaky feeling in my stomach.
Oh, I always get that feeling after a good fight.
This ain't about fighting. It's another kind of feeling. Millie reckons it's about Alice.
Oh, now don't tell me Gideon's starting to get ideas about women.
Not women. Just one.
Like a lost little calf, I don't mean to laugh or tease you. Where's your sense? There are so many girls with long golden curls to please you. Love comes and goes away, you're hurting by.
Isn't just any girl. I know that love's not a game. Alice isn't just any girl.
At heart, every girl's the same. Every girl's the same.
Not her, not her. Not her. About her. I reckon I love her.
Quit your fretting. You'll find that one girl's pretty much like another.
Just any girl. I know that
that love's not a game.
Adam isn't just any man.
Just see yourselves. You all been looking like a bunch of lovesick bull calves more than a month now. Got calico on the brain? Why don't you boys make everybody happy and just go marry those girls?
Them folks won't even let us back into town.
How can we marry them if we can't even court them?
Well, who says you got to court them?
Millie says we do.
Millie? Did I have to court her? Just go marry them.
Oh, sure. Just like that.
They wouldn't let us marry them for 1,000 years.
1,000 years? Yeah, well, why don't you do it like some Romans did with their sobbing women or Sabine women, or whatever you call them. I've been reading about it in one of Millie's books. Them Romans was in the same fix you're in. They was opening up new territory, and the women was scarce. Now there were these sobbing women down in the town. And what did those old Romans do? They up and carried them off! Well, of course, this being Oregon and God-fearing territory, you'll have to carry off with a parson along with them.
Them Romans, they the ones settled up north of here?
Oh, no, Frank. Those are Mormons. Oh. This is olden times. This is history. Tell you about them sobbing women who lived in the Roman days. It seemed that they all went swimming while their men was out to graze. Well, the Roman troop was riding by and saw them in their meal mice. So we took them all back home to dry, if that's what Purok says. Oh, yes, and the women were sobbing, 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 fit to be tied. Every muscle was throbbing, throbbing from their riotous ride. Oh, they cried and kissed and cried all over that Roman countryside. So don't forget that when you're taking a ride. Sobbing fit to be tied from that riotous ride.
Then what happened?
Yeah. They never did return their plunder, the big nuggets all the blue. They carried them home by thunder, two rotunds, small, cute. And they'll never see, so they tell me, it's downright domesticity. With a Roman baby on his knee, named Claudius and Root.
Oh, yes!
And the women was sobbing, 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 passing the night. Oh, the Romans was going out, I'm now it's starting a fight. They kept occupied by sewing lots of little togas for their tots. And saying someday, women folk will arise.
Passing all of them guys.
Just sewing
while the Romans had fights.
Because it's true, a lesson to the likes of you. We'd have rough like them, they're always new, or else they'll think you're attached.
Adam, what would Newby say?
Well, surprise her!
Oh, yes! Then the women was sobbing, 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 buckets of tears.
What he said?
On account of old Dobbin, Dobbin really rattled their ears.
And that ain't all! Oh, they acted angry and annoyed.
Simply, they was overjoyed.
You might recall that when Corellin you
oh, 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 the poor little
dear. Let's go get them!
Sobbing heifers!
Oh, yes, them the women were sobbing, sobbing, sobbing.
Frank, these are women.
Right.
Now remember, keep out of sight, or you'll end up with a rifle up your nose. What are you waiting for? Go get him!
Yeah!
Shh!
Sarah, be a sport. Just one little kiss.
Well, Zeke, maybe just a little one. But you gotta close your eyes first. Why, Zeke! Frank!
Tabby's got the crew.
I'll help Luke find her.
Now, Ruth, don't you stay out there too long. Go catch the crew, too.
Here, kitty, kitty. Here, kitty. Caleb!
Are you afraid of mice?
Oh, yes.
They have to scare me to death.
Good!
This time, we'll put an end to that pod piece.
Yeah!
Yeah, we should have strung him up years ago.
Yeah!
It will make so much to lay a hand on any of those girls.
Yeah!
Get him, boys! Get him! Do you hear?
We came. There was an avalanche.
Yeah.
wasn't it?
Oh no, I'd say it was more yours. It all come out of that book about them sodden women.
What kind of men are you? A bunch of wild animals?
No, they're just bold pups in love is all.
I want my mother.
Oh, Alice, please don't cry. I'm sorry, honest. It was the only way I could get you to marry me.
Oh.
Adam!
What?
We forgot to get the parson!
Don't let him cry, girls. Nothing's gonna happen. I promise you.
Go on.
This house is for the girls. You boys are not gonna set one foot in that house while they're here. You're gonna roost in the barn with the rest of the animals. Now get out. All of you. I'm ashamed of you.
Now, Millie.
You too.
Everything's gonna turn out just fine. Me and the boys will get the preacher up here somehow.
Oh, do you reckon those girls are gonna marry him now?
Well, aren't you the one that wanted them married with wives of their own?
Sure I did. Wives they married. Not stole.
We didn't steal anything, Millie.
I made it too easy for you, Adam. You had such a way with words, but I should have seen who you were. It was there plain as day.
Now, Millie, before you go saying something new
to me, I have begun to say what's on my mind.
You've said enough.
How could you have done this without talking to me first?
Dad, blame it! You come in here bossing my brothers around. Tell them how to dress, how to eat, how to think, how to talk, making sissies out of them. Pretty soon they won't be able to use the outhouse without you showing them how.
I've only been showing the boys how things are done. What's wrong with that? Besides, they don't seem to mind, Adam.
Anybody can teach a dog to sit. That don't mean it's in that dog's nature.
What are you saying, Adam?
I'm saying that I'm the head of this household, Millie. Me and my brothers. We're sleeping in the house where we belong.
No, Adam.
No. No!
Adam, Millie's right. It wouldn't be proper.
We'll stay in the barn. You leave things be.
Yeah.
Leave things be? Well, ain't this just a fine how-to-do? If that's what you want, that's what you can have. Me? I'm getting out of here.
Adam, come back out here and talk to us.
I've had enough talking. I'm leaving.
Adam, listen to your brothers.
The last time I listened to my brothers, I ended up getting married. I would have been better off with a higher cab. I can still see my papa chopping trees and planting crops I can't forget. His toil and sweat. I can still see my mama kissing him at the door, her face all flushed bright. She knew how hard he tried. He was one of those tough young men who blaze new trails through gales of fallen snow and never let go. He was father to seven sons. He taught us how to ride and hunt and fight. He made it so damn tough, and he was right. Where were you? Barn burned to the ground. Where were you when Caleb nearly drowned? And where were you that day that Mama died? The boys had to grow up fast. When Mama passed, they had to face the bitter world alone. My pa worked himself to death before Gideon could walk, and I never once heard Mama cross him. You hear that, Billy? Never went to the socials. I was too busy seeing that the boys had lost. So no one froze. Father froze them before me, risking lives on the Missouri Trail, but they pushed on. Sure a gun, so determined to tame this country, their families were dying every day. But they worked and prayed. Blood was being spilled. Where were you when
town could be in bells. It takes a man who has a lion's heart. So I'm not gonna let you in and let you win by tearing us apart. It took a man of honor to shape this land. It took a man who stood just where I stand. Their woman stayed beside them night and day.
Herself down. Did you see how Alice danced? Never seen such curves.
Stop it, stop it, stop it, stop it. You're getting on our nerves.
Miss Ruth?
Miss Dorcas?
Miss Alice?
Miss Liza?
Miss Martha?
Miss Sarah? We want each of you.
Especially you, Miss Alice.
To know how deeply and sincerely we apologize for what we did.
Miss Alice.
And we want each of you to accept these tokens of our very deep affection.
Miss Alice.
Made this for you.
On behalf of the girls, thank you. Now, please, go on about your chores and let us get back to ours.
Millie!
Lily, I'm real worried about Adam. He's been up on the ridge more than a month. I suppose he was to get sicker, break a leg or something. The wolves are real bad this time of year.
The wolves will be great company for him.
I could go up to the ridge and ask Adam to come home.
Gideon! Your chores are waiting. Adam Pontipi! Adam Pontipi.
For the past 3 weeks.
Ruth, Sarah, move away from that window.
I find it disgusting that you're standing where they can see you.
I wonder which one of them slept in this bed.
Dorcas?
Holly. What? Didn't it ever occur to you that you're sleeping in one of their beds?
I've thought of no such thing. I never even think of those brutes.
Well then, what were you doing yesterday? Behind the woodpile? Certainly weren't thinking then.
How dare you?
I saw it with my own eyes.
So did I.
You take that back.
Make me.
No! Come on, get a room. Get over here.
Stop it!
Stop! Girls!
Please, don't fight. What the boy said was sweet, wasn't it?
Yeah. Millie, don't you miss Adam? Even just a little bit?
I try not to think about it.
We know how you feel.
Yes, we do.
You do?
We feel the same way. Oh, good! Then let's all have dinner together.
Oh, Alice, you don't want to have this? You know the rules.
Millie, what are we gonna do?
What are we gonna do?
Be strong!
Well, what are we gonna do the rest of the time?
We've got plenty of things to do. Well, tend to the house, make new clothes for ourselves, and for the baby.
Baby? Who's having a baby?
Me and Adam.
Oh, oh your baby?
Does Adam know?
No.
Oh, Millie, that's terrible. How come you didn't know?
Well, Alice, I didn't reckon it was time to tell him. I figured we better get things worked out between us first. I'm thinking of going back east. Back home.
By yourself?
With a baby?
Millie, don't feel bad. Things could be a lot worse.
We could all be having babies.
Oh, no! Dorcas!
You girls will be back in town with your families.
Ugh, and those dreary town boys.
Dorcas!
Millie, we don't want to go home.
You mean you really want to stay?
There are plenty of reasons to like it here.
6 of them.
So, you like the boys.
I know.
Yes! Yes!
Maybe someday.
Like today, or maybe tomorrow?
You've got to make it through the winter and hope for some loving in the spring. You've got to make it through the winter. Time will come when church bells will start to
till the spring.
Oh.
matter? Got tired of sleeping out in the barn?
Oh, I'm doing fine, Adam.
Oh, yeah? How are your brothers?
They're doing real fine, too. A lot's happened since you left.
Oh?
Yeah. Millie finally let me and the boys hoard the girls. So everything's real good with us.
Oh. Is that why you come up here? Tell me that?
I come to get you. And take you back with me. It's spring back at the farm.
Yeah, well, ain't up here yet.
Adam. Millie's had a baby. It came the day before yesterday.
I don't believe it.
It's just as true as my being here.
I don't believe it. It's just her trick to get me back. Yeah, well, I ain't going.
Not even to see the baby? Your own kin. Adam, your little girl.
A girl? Well, I might have known she'd have a girl.
She's the spitting image of you, Adam.
Yeah?
You don't know any more about babies than you do, Millie.
Well, I do know that she's gone and changed all of you.
She hasn't changed us. We was wrong. And you thinking that she'd do something sneaky to trick you, Adam, Millie ain't that kind. She's a proud and spunky lady, but she ain't never gonna bring herself to ask you back.
Yeah, well, she'd only be wasting her breath anyway, because I don't aim on going.
Millie misses you. Adam, you being my eldest brother, I've always looked up to you. I've even tried to be like you. But today, I feel so ashamed of you. Now I know you can lick me. You can lick the tar out of me. But I wouldn't hold myself, no kind of man, unless I showed you how I felt.
Are you done now?
Yes, sir.
Tell him I'll be back when the pass is open. I'll stay with you till the shooting is out. Now get!
Am I stubborn and unbending? Is she really depending on me? Can it be? Is my brother
right?
staring at? I told you I'll be back when the pass is open.
The pass!
Go on inside, girls. Go on.
Boys, go get the wagon hitched up.
The wagon?
And bring plenty of blankets and straw. We're taking the girls back to town.
Oh, you can't be serious.
I said, we're taking the girls back to town.
Adam, that will be dangerous for the boys.
She's a pretty little thing. Ain't she not small?
She's the right size, Adam.
What's your name, her?
Hannah. Picking up where your mother left off.
Hannah.
It's not written down yet. We can change it.
It's a good name. Thinking up there in the mountains. Thinking about our little girl. And what I would do if someone came a sneaking and carried her off. Why, I'd kill the son of a gun. I'd string him up to the nearest tree. I'd shoot him like I would a thieving fox. I got to thinking about you up there, too.
Did you, Adam?
Seems like I couldn't get you off my mind.
And?
Millie, I already said.
Well, I heard what you said, Adam, but...
Dang, woman! You should have been talked with. I've never been much for apologies. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Billy. Billy, did you hear me?
I hear you, Adam.
And I'm happy the baby's a Billy.
You are?
Well, I can see she makes you happy, Billy.
I'm sorry, too.
You are?
I'm sorry I married a pig-headed, stubborn, ornery, sweet-talking.
Try to run.
Love never goes away. It back.
Oh, Adam, you will be careful.
Don't worry. Of course I will.
Adam, we ain't gonna let you do it. We've talked it over, we've all agreed. We ain't gonna let you take them back.
They ain't going.
There are girls now, Adam.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I'm still the head of this household, and I say we're taking them back.
I reckon you're gonna have to show me.
Me too.
Don't you see that taking them back's the only way you're gonna get to keep them? We'll have the whole town down on us.
So let them come, we'll fight them all.
Yeah.
Yeah, and who are you gonna be fighting? They're kinfolk, that's who. Someone's bound to get hurt. A father or a brother, maybe. You think those girls are gonna marry you after that?
Adam's right. I stand Adam.
Yeah, well, don't stand too close.
Adam! The girls run away! They don't want to go back to town. They want to stay here with the boys.
We'll go get them! Bring them back!
Martha! Martha!
giddy up, giddy up!
Come on, Liza!
No, I won't! No!
It's too late, it's too late, you wedded husbands?
We do.
And do you, Adam, Benjamin, Caleb, Daniel, Ephraim, Frankincense? And Gideon, take these girls to be your lawful wedded wives?
We do!
Then I pronounce you man and wife, 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 and once again, I repeat, man and lawful wedded wife. You may now kiss the brides.
Thank you.